Welcome to Homesteading the Pioneer Way. Well, I left my phone in the car and didn't get a chance to, well, it was actually helping him get in here. He had to maneuver through trees and things, and we had to help him. And so I forgot to turn it on and film it, but here's my cabin. And I've got it facing the driveway. It's not exactly the angle I wanted it, but it'll be good enough. It's in the curve. See, we come right here, and then it starts curving. And I wanted it between this tree and over here, facing this way, but it's kind of facing this way. But that'll be all right. It's here, and I'm proud of it. I'm thankful it's here. And the next one is going to go right, I'm thinking about building on to this side, bedroom and bath, and then building a porch on that side, and then right over in here, there'll be another one, 12 by 30, but it will be long ways. The door will be on the long side instead of the end. And then next to it will be an antebellum between those other two trees out there. It'll be a 12 by 24. And then I'll build a Victorian and an Italian. So things are looking up. I think my grandson is about ready to go. We had to get up at 6 o'clock this morning and get this done. I believe it's 9 now. Took us that long to get out here and get it set down. So, oh man. I gotta build me some steps. Anyway, I am going to. It's gotten scuffed up. I don't know how it got scuffed up. I'm gonna lock the door. And we will be ready to go get this. This is my grandson's. He said we could leave the refrigerator in there. But you know how they tilt them up so high. I put this strap between the, from the door through the window. I put it through the window and the refrigerator was right there. So we strapped it twice around the refrigerator and then around the freezer door and secured it. So that is what's going on the homestead today, and I am wore out and hungry. We've got to get something to eat and get home. And my daughter, I would stay all day if I could, but my goats and dogs and ducks and all the animals, roosters and chickens, they're usually fed before now, and it's another hour and a half before we can get home. So they will be screaming their head off, so I got to get home and feed them, and I'll just have to come back another time. But my daughter and son-in-law are coming this afternoon, and I think they're going to spend the night and tomorrow. So that's what's going on in the homestead today. I've already locked up in here. I got John, I got your thing, and I've already locked up, so we're ready to go if you are. You going to drive? You want me to?
I'm driving. You just sleep.
Huh? Anyway, progress on the homestead. Oh, and I've already cleared out. I don't know if I've showed you before. I've already cleared out. This is material that we've got out here. I've got the roof already for another 12 by 20. There's a little shed. It's got to be put together. Looks like somebody's come out here and throw garbage. We've had people coming out here camping, and they've even burnt some of my lumber that we brought out here to build some things with. This is our makeshift bathroom. We've got a 5-gallon bucket with one of those little commode seat things to go on it. But right here I have cleared out. Looks like that storm that just came through has knocked some limbs down. But I had cleared out here to put another one in. And then I'm going to be putting another one in over here. So it'll be one like here, and then my house, and then another one here. So they won't be right across from each other. See, if I was going to have one right across, it'd be right here. But I'm clearing out for things. I think right here will be another one. I think we'll have one right here. I'm looking for places that it's kind of clear that we don't have to cut much. So, you know, that one tree have to be cut. And this tree to this tree looks like probably about 15, 16 foot. So that would be fine for another one. Cut that little tree and it looks like it'd be 20 foot or more deep. So just cut this little brush and one tree and looks like this will be a nice spot. And see, my house is there. And then I'll have another one right here. So I'm going to have several little houses. And we'll have two more on this side farther down. So it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4. And then around the corner will be my daughter and grandson's. So that's 6. And this one will be 7. Mine's 8. 9. The farmhouse. 10. The antebellum. 11. The Victorian. And 12 will be an Italian. And then in the woods, I'm going to have some little tiny ones. Probably 8 by 10 or maybe 10 by 10. I'm going to have 4 cut in those woods. One is going to be a sewing room. All my sewing stuff, material, everything. I mean, we don't have a big house, so I'm going to have a sewing room, a laundry where you keep all your laundry stuff, and then I'll have a herb house to dry. When I pick all my herbs, then I will put them in there and hang them up and dry them and have some shelves to put my salves and medicines and herbal blends to cook with and all that. And then I will have an outdoor kitchen and an outhouse and an outdoor shower. So, a lot to be done. A lot of money that I don't have, so we're having to do this just as we can. But it's coming along. We've got 3 out here now. So, till next time, this is Homesteading the Pioneer Way, saying, keep homesteading.